Hello, beautiful people, future me. This week we are attacking in my programming workout the execute program exercises. So let's get started with it. We started with 5 minutes of typing. So let's do that. Oi. Oh, I'll start the time. And let's do C++ with good, okay. Four and a half minutes. Let's call it 3% and 41 VPM. It's good score for me at least. For some reason, I did not feel like it's a good. I'm doing. I'm performing well. It's interesting. Oh well. So we have that behind ourselves, and next we will go on to the TypeScript. Seems like I started something in here, but let's just go to the courses. We'll choose randomly what we will do today. And we have three options: TypeScript, SQL, and modern JavaScript. So I'll use this random picker to choose randomly which topic I will be working on. It looks like a JavaScript to me. Congratulations, JavaScript. You are the chosen one. So I have a modern JavaScript there. So let's do it. Use bind to call the get address string function with addresses bound to this. Okay, so it will be this dot, and I will invoke it. Okay, so it will be address string like so dot bind, and then we say address, and we want to invoke it. What is wrong? Cannot read city of undefined. This is the same, right? ADDRESS, ADDRESS. Looks same to me at least. Typo. Module. Okay, so. Think bind module. You can do it on a when on a const. I thought it has to be a function. Huh. Interesting. Well. I still think I did it correctly. Use bind to call. To get address string function, maybe without those. Yeah, because I'm calling it in here. I see. So this is probably the problem. It should be get address string dot without those highlighted bananas. Okay. So delete user, no, I cannot delete like that. Const user name. We don't have a defined name in here, right? So that is a error. Write double numbers, template literal tag, it mimics normal string interpolation, but doubles all of the interpolated values as they are inserted. We'll do that. And two for cycles in here, we will do result dot push those equals strings at the ith position. Right, then we will have a for. Now we have if I is smaller than values dot length dh, then we will append that guy, so result plus equals values at the ith position times two. So you want to double it, right? And we need, so this is the end of the if, end of the for, and we will return the result. And we'll close the function. Let me go over it once again. So we have a for cycle result. We are appending like so. This is multiplied by two. Looks kind of good to me. And it is. Write a function that picks a key out of an object. It takes an object and a key as a string. The function lets us to be sloppy by writing the key in incorrect case, converts the key to the lower case, and then returns the value that object has at lower case letter. Okay. Use the structuring with computed property syntax to extract the value from the object. Oh. All right. So we'll do that. So, and we will have our return, and here will be the object. Right, inside here will be the computed property, so it will be the key dot to lower case. And we want to take it from the object we have been given, so bj looks good. Moment of uncertainty. OBJ key EY TOLOWER CACE. Let's go. Oh crap. unexpected token. Yeah, because I should not be returning an object, I should be returning just that value. So, and the computed properties index, so I think it will be without the curly braces. That was my mistake, I think. We'll try it once again. If not, I will find out. Outer, inner, so this is outer, because this one is lives in this scope. Is none undefined, so this is true. Okay, I found something which I keep forgetting. That's good. And return first argument. So we'll get a object here. First arc will be one. Second arc will be an array, and this will have a two in it, I believe. Okay. Strings. First of all, is an array. Second of all, it will have the empty empty. Empty string in there. So two mistakes in there. So next one. We will add things, return x and y, add numbers. Well, this will work. This will return 3. Write a function that takes a user and returns a login count object from for them, mapping their name to their logic count. Use a computed property to construct the object. Our pre-written code will call your function for multiple users. So start somewhere, close this, and we will return something, return, and there will be an object, and we want the name, so it will be user.name, and then will be user, I see, so it will be like this, and then we have that. User dot login count maybe. I'm not sure about this colon in here. I think it is like this. Well, let's try. Oh, and I'm correct. Good. Good, good. So, what do we have here? So, we have a user object, then we have a function username, and it says this name, And that object, that function username dot bind user is on the user. So now we have a username bound call. So this will return Amir. Okay. Is none true? User. But the const okay, so this is a getter, and we have a name we will assign the user. So we'll get the property because this is like the field in there, right? So we'll get Betty. But I'm not like 100% like feel right in there, so I think this thing I will have to do more often. So is none without a number, I think this is false. Okay. Something I need to go over. Good. Amir name. Yeah, well, this is a true. And I will not count the empty spaces again, but that's the same exercise I was doing. Write a function that writes out a sum the long way. Use template literals to build a string including two numbers and the final sum. So we will return, and this will be like this: x plus, and then we will take the variable y, and let's say equal, and we will do x. We will evaluate here x plus y. Come on. Here we go. We close the string literal, string template. What are you doing? Pressing random things. That's what I'm doing. No. This looks good. Use a single object, the structuring operation two. Export the username into the name value. Put all of the other keys and values into a rest variable. So view object, okay, and we will have a definition of the constant name, and rest, and equals to user, like so. That's correct. I'll just repeat that. I did constant. Then, when we are destructuring object, we use the curly brace, and we put in the name of the variables in the order. Well, what do we have? Name, get name, city, age. Then we have a user, which is okay. So this is showing that we don't have to do name equals name if it has the same or this name equals name. We can do use this shorthand and. When we will do the array, it will be name will be Amir, and the age is 36. Next we have numbers. On index 3 is A, and we are pushing in it like all the entries from numbers. So it will be three times undefined, and 0, 1, 2 will be undefined, and then we will have a. Undefined a. Okay. What next? Function f. If true, let that return x. Okay, so we are using the strict mode in here, first of all, which does not matter because we are referencing to x, which is not defined in the function scope. In this scope, this x is defined only in here. This one has a block scope, so it lives only in here, and this is an error. So I will say error and expect glory. Second chance. Okay, so this is the one which I called the thing. So first we will reference the get address string, get address string without these, no, dot bind, and we will bind it on address object, and this new function which will be returned by it, we will invoke. This is correct. Thank you. Write a function that picks a key out of an object. It takes an object and a key as a string. The function lets us to be sloppy, writing the key in incorrect case. It converts the case to lowercase, using the lowercase, and so on. Structuring with computed property syntax to extract the value from the object. And I don't remember what was the mistake in here I did, so I will try and inspect. So we will return, also we'll close this right away, and they want only the property, so it will be obj, and we'll use the computer property, which will be key dot to lower case, like so. That will return the key but in lowercase, and we want to return only the string, so this should be it, and it is. Okay, so number is an undefined. Undefined is that is not a number, so I would think this is true, and it's not. Okay, so that's my second mistake. So I will have a look. And I will do number is then undefined. And that will return. It's not a number. Undefined is not a number. Okay. So, oh yeah, and this one, first argument will be an array. That was the thing, that was the mistake. So we'll have an object. The first argument is an array, and we have a 1, and then we have an empty string, like so. And the second argument is array as well, and we will have a values in here. We have only 1, that is right in there, the 2. And that should be correct, I hope, at least. Second R. And it is! Okay, so is none, none, that is true. Yep, okay. So. That is good, and we have a 30 seconds to do something else, so let's do what? I'll call it. Food is ready. Okay, so we are done. Done is better than perfect. The main thing is to keep the practice. So, we'll see you next time. Have a nice day. Bye.